Well, my name is Kirsten van Dam and I'm owner of a company called Out of Office, which is a trend brand and design agency in Amsterdam. We do fully integrated branding and design projects, and it starts with trend research and can be translated in branding, brand consultancy, brand direction and design. How I came to, or how my career developed, well, I obviously first studied industrial design, and then after that I wanted to have a graduation project, and I couldn't find one, and then which was typically because I wanted to do something in interior design. I applied for a company in Amsterdam, and it took a while before I got the answer. So in that time, I got a extra internship in Sweden. So I was on my way to Sweden when I got a phone call that my internship, I wasn't allowed, or how do you say that? They didn't like me enough. So I was very disappointed, but on my way to Sweden. And at that point, I had to find a new graduation project. And well, I think the best thing I learned in Sweden at that time is that I met a Brazilian guy, and there are a lot of international people. And when I told him the story that I was denied to do the internship, he was super surprised. He said, well, what's your plan B, or what's your plan C or D? Because I was so used that everything was always going the way I wanted. That, that I had to find something else. And he basically said, yeah, you always have to go, if you plan A doesn't work, you go to plan B or plan C. And I kind of realized, yeah, that's maybe the easy way you are used to in Holland, that everything goes exactly how you plan. While he was from Brazil, and the journey he had to take to come from Sweden was much longer. So at that point, I decided to find something else and ended up at Nike European headquarters. Did my graduation, my master's project there, and then I ended up in consumer insight and trend research at Nike, which I really liked. Then got a job offered at a trend consultancy agency in Amsterdam, where I met my current business partner, Sam Carlijn. And yeah, that's how I ended up in Out of Office. That's a good question. Well, I didn't have a real plan, still don't have a real plan what I wanted to become. I knew I was, I liked creativity and I liked design and products, and basically that's how I started industrial design. So there wasn't really a long-term vision what I wanted to become. And I ended up having my own company, so I worked in several working environments, which was multinational environment. Company, and then a smaller company, and then my own company. And I think that's the flow it went. So I think the most important thing, you learn a lot, not at the university, I think, and you also learn a lot, but you don't, obviously you don't learn the whole professionalism, like what you the real work experience, working with clients, working with different people. But I think the most important thing is that your vision is still narrow. I think as soon as I came off university, well, everyone in university has a certain path, and that's a university path. So everybody knows their companies, and it's this really small community in industrial design, especially in Delft. Everybody knows each other. And I think as soon as you go out of that scene or community, you meet so many other people. You basically, your life opens up, and I think whether it's companies or new connections or new people, it's always good to meet people who think differently, because then at that point you start thinking also differently, and that made me look to different areas and also to different ways how you can accomplish something. So I think being, and that's what I always say to students now as well, is just go out of university and meet different academies, different companies, different people, because there are a lot of things how things can be done, and it's not only the one route. Well, first of all, the work itself, the content, otherwise I wasn't doing what I was doing. But one of the things that Out of Office does, we work with a network of influential people. That's how we gain our get our information from. And this network we call Network 404 or 404 Network. And these people give me energy. They are fresh-minded, they are authentic, they are original, and most of the time they are still under the radar, so quite invisible. And we talk to those people to get insights in developments. If we have a certain topic, we talk to them, and they are really passionate about what they do. So not only do we get the insight from them, but we also work per project with a team of experts that we are sourcing from the world. And also working in this team of people who are doing it because they like doing it and not for the money, is amazing. So it's really nice. And also doing only projects you like and not for a boss, which is also nice. Did actually a few good projects, but two, I think, projects we are really proud of. One is that we do a lot of work in China, and last year we were asked to go to Shanghai to develop a new brand for the Shanghai market, starting from scratch. So we did a big trend research in Shanghai about women. It had to be a high-end fashion brand. Then we developed it with a team of creatives into a new name, a new logo, the whole brand identity, the whole corporate identity, the whole guidelines for the Chinese team, but also a brand store, which is now being built in Shanghai. And being able to do that with your own company was amazing, and it got really a good success. It's called Zoe Moi. Another project I'm really proud of is one in Holland we just did for Overijssel, which is about the new retail reality, so basically on the future of retail. And also that one is really nice because it's for a client that is maybe out of our normal zone, so they are more the governmental institution. And our added value for them was big, and that's also what we like. That project as well. There are a couple of advices. First of all, what I already said is to explore, to go out of university, to connect with other people, with new mindset, but also to understand your critical thinking for yourself. To travel loads and maybe even to learn another language like Chinese or Russian, because in the end the future is not only in Holland or in the English language, but I think it's bigger than that. It's always hard to predict how it should develop, because it develops, but I think a given is that the world will change. So the only constant thing at the moment is that there's change. So how it will develop, we don't know, but we know it will change. And in order to be relevant for the change, you need to be flexible. And that's the thing we advise for companies or CEOs or managers, is it's not the survival of the fittest, but it's the survival of the most adaptable, most flexible mind. Well, the dreams we have as Out of Office is to continue on bigger projects and really being able to add your own value into projects, to have be able to have more time on longer term projects like we did on the research for the new retail reality. We are now working on a new project, it's called the Future of Education, which is also a long term project on how education and learning will develop in the future. A personal dream of mine would also be able to tap into more development areas. So obviously we work a lot of times in Europe or in more developed countries, but like we did in Asia, but also maybe moving into Africa or Brazil, India countries where you can still add more value into areas. Maybe that's a dream of ours. Yes, well, obviously, since we are working with a good network of positive, inspiring people, we always ask if you have great ideas or you want to be part of the network or are interested in the work we do as Out of Office. You should go to our website, it's www.outofoffice.cc, and yeah, we are always open to new mindset and new thinking, so yeah, you're welcome.